Hey guys, this is Eddie the Magic Monk. Welcome to another Expert System lesson. So last lesson, you have already learned about what an expert system is. Basically, it is a computer program that simulates a human expert. And last lesson, you also had a go at using an expert system to help you select what kind of sport you should play. So in this lesson, we're going to talk about what that expert system is made up of before we start building one. So an expert system is made up of three sections. The first section is the knowledge base. The knowledge base is the information inside the expert system represented as a series of if-then statements. An if-then statement is basically a statement saying that if a certain condition is satisfied, then we can reach a particular conclusion. So have a look at our sports expert system. Let's say the condition is if you like running and if you like physical contact and if you prefer throwing the ball, then your favorite sport is basketball. Okay, so that is part of the knowledge base of the expert system that I have just created. Now, obviously, if you create your own expert system, then you would probably have some better factual knowledge than what I have created as an example. So that is the knowledge base. And as you know, I have probably about 8 sports in my expert system. So each sport would have a list of statements like this in the knowledge base. Okay, so that is the knowledge base. Let's talk about what the inference engine is. The inference engine is the part of our expert system that controls the steps taken to solve the problem. So let's have a look at how our expert system solves the problem. Now, basically, our expert system follows this decision tree to solve the problem. And if you have a look, initially, the first question we ask is, do you like running? If the user answers yes, then we follow forward onto the first branch. If the user answers no, then we go down to the second branch. And we keep going forward until we reach a conclusion. Now, this process of going forward through a list of conditions is called forward chaining. Now, when I created the expert system, what I did was I actually wrote down a list of sports that I knew about, and I created these conditions through a process of backward chaining. And the difference between the two, forward chaining and backward chaining, is with forward chaining, you don't know what the end result is, and you're trying to figure out the end result by answering a series of questions. And whereas with backward chaining, you know what the end result is and you go backwards to figure out what each of the conditions are. The last part of the expert system is the shell, which represents the user interface for accessing and creating the expert system. So the shell that we're going to use to create our expert system is called ESBuilder. And in our next lesson, we're going to show you guys how to use the shell to create your own expert system. See you guys next time. Thanks for watching. Bye.